piston stunt fights for a Western action show are kind of important. Wild Wild West turned out to have far more fist fights than gunfights. By about 4-1. So I'm going to make two videos. This one about stunt-filled action fights. Stunt-filled indeed. And another one about gunfights. The fights were generally with the same batch of stuntmen, which you will start to recognize. The show tried to change around clothing and makeup, but you can tell. This was actually a huge advantage for planning out the stunts. Robert Conrad knew all the guys, and they knew him, and they could work out a fight amongst themselves pretty quickly, and relatively safely. The stunt fights were usually planned out on the set quickly, and then the director would figure out where to put the camera. Conrad was in exceptionally good shape for the task of doing his own stunts, which he took great pride in. He worked out every day using a grueling routine, which gave him the strength and flexibility to do his fights and to look good without a shirt on. He'd run several miles each morning, perform 22 karate katas, do pull-ups and sit-ups, 200 sit-ups a day on an incline board, just to make things that much harder. Conrad was a black belt in karate, training first in the Kempo style and then the Shokata style, from which comes his stylized martial arts stances and his orientally inspired fight scenes. The one thing he could not do was karate kicks because of the tight pants that he wore. What it meant was that Conrad was the most physically fit man on the set by far, and allowed him to survive doing all those stunts which he insisted on performing himself. And he was required to do it each and every week on each and every shooting day. So here's some of his karate styles. This one's very Bruce Lee-like. And this one is karate against kung fu, where Jim is using his karate styles and the other actor is using something rather like tiger kung fu. Interesting music, huh?
Now let me say, Mr. West, that I will most assuredly kill you. But first, I will enjoy beating you to a pulp. Concentration, Mr. West. Concentration. That is your destination. I hope you had a good look.
One of the favorite locations for these stunt fights was stairways, which allowed for multi-level fights and, of course, falls. There were occasional injuries on the set of such a stunt-heavy show, most of which involved the stuntmen themselves, who expected it. But only two affected production. Notice there's no music. We'll talk about that later. Here's one of the stuntmen getting injured. This is Red West. That piano was supposed to crack like this, and it didn't the first time. Cut his head open right good. Russ Martin actually broke his leg during the filming of a third season episode, you know, The Avaricious Actuary, which caused him to appear with a broken leg, which we will see for several third season episodes. Later on, in the fourth season, during filming of Fire and Brimstone, he will have a massive heart attack, which darn near killed him. And that's one of the reasons that Ross Martin got replaced by Jeremy Pike and various others in a number of fourth season episodes. He just was unable to perform.
Oh, I'm sorry I can't go with you, James. But I'll join you there as soon as my leg
gets
better.
Here he is with a...
ten cuidado tolu!
Crutched mascot. Conrad himself had one major failure. Here it is, right here. He's going to grab the chandelier and supposed to swing on it, but he lets go early and whangs on his neck. Did him serious damage. You watch the stuntman, he falls back as if he's been hit, just because that's the stunt. But watch Robert Conrad just... So let's go, oops, and tries to kick, and then wham, down his neck. And it was very dangerous, and like I said, Donner killed him. In selecting fistfights, I discovered something kind of surprising, and that is that they're all short. Not much more than a minute in length. They feel longer because they're so full of action. And I think it's a sign of a well-delivered stunt fight, is that you're so wrapped up in it, it feels longer. Gym on gym action. And the karate stance again.
Which one is which? Stay right where you are. Ernest, let's get out of here. I said stay where you are. How do I know you're not him?
So here's a fight without music. Here's a couple of fights. And I want you to notice how sterile they seem. And you wonder why they ever thought this was a good idea. But there were several fairly exuberant fights that had no music.
72 degrees elevation.
72 degrees elevation. Mark.
No good, West. It's too
late. That's Bob Duvall, by the way.
The timing sequence has started. It cannot be stopped.
In a role he'd probably forget, want to forget.
And we will be blown to bits!
Now here's one where they put the music in. It's just more exciting this one. Now let's try it again with no music. Now this is a very exuberant jump around fight. But without music it just ain't got the same thing. Love that skeleton. By the way, the guy going upstairs is Jack Elam. A longtime character performer. There he is.
My future bride shall share my table. No doubt another victim can be found to appease the hunger of the Pacto.
Guards, seize him.
One more no music fight. It just ain't the same. I mean, I suppose it's more realistic, but so. The music was, there were, you know, just a sequence of musics, but at least it wasn't as bad as Star Trek, where there was exactly one fight music.
Okay.
That's Alan Hale Jr., the skipper from Gilligan's Island.
Hey, you play the guitar?
No, I don't.
Well, stick around and sing with
me. Here's one with a weird music. This Buffalo Gal stuff.
Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight.
Which gets really annoying after a while.
Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Come out. Come out tonight. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight. Come out tonight. Won't you come out tonight? Dance by the light of the moon. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight. Come out tonight. Buffalo Gal, won't you come out tonight?
Here's one of those musics again that we recognize after a while. I think he was supposed to go out the window, but didn't work. So this is another stair fight. It's just is with different kind of stairs, and we'll see that they tweak that around a little bit.
This is not Rosa Montebello, you fools! How could you have made such a horrendous mistake? Get rid of her!
That's Richard Kiel, and this is one of the jumpiest stair fights of the whole show. This is another stair fight, but this one's done just on a big pile of dirt. It's kind of an interesting variation, as we will see.
Go get some coffee. We'll take over for you now. Hey!
The other kind was that showed up a lot was a bar fight. And the nice thing about bars is that you can break lots of stuff. So and throw people and then smash him into that and over there and smash that. There's Jeremy Pike running away. I love this guy on the pool table. He just jumps up and down. Fighting and not very well. Ross Martin didn't do many of his own stunts. He wanted to, sort of, but he did wound up not doing many. Once Ross Martin was asked, "What's the difference between the two of you?" And he said, "He fights and I act." The other thing about bar fights is they could just sort of escalate. And there's a wall that didn't do very well.
You murdering skunk, you'll never get away with this.
Well, I'm sure gonna try.
You're nothing but a bunch of murderers.
That's right, and you keep yapping like you are, and I'm gonna...
But sometimes
right
Artie did fight with Jim or even by himself. This one, he's being a distraction.
Tennyson? Why did you do that?
Prepare to defend yourself, sir. May I have a little room, please?
Hold it.
What were you trying to do?
All right, now, listen, there's no cause for you to be getting that upset about it, is there?
No, because when you get upset, we get upset, and
there's bad guys all around. So Jim and Artie getting upset. They got them all.
Face of vastly superior numbers, I would say the enemy withdrew.
Lock that guy upstairs.
Now here's Artie providing a distraction again and joining in the fight with gusto.
Thank you.
That's already in the beard. This one, Artie's in disguise as a barkeeper. Do what he can to assist without blowing his cover. And yes, they fist fight, all wearing guns. Just go with it, okay? It's Artie as the postal guy. Now this one is where both of them act sort of Jim-like.
Hold it.
Now you might think that Jim is, you know, your typical action hero. He never loses. But that's not really true. Every once in a while, he will get boffed right good and either get captured or just outright defeated.
Like so.
So Harry looks like he's winning. Not a very solid wall back there.
Don't waste your time talking to a chair. I'm in here.
might recognize that staircase. Pow. And he's out. This is the one that Robert Conrad gets injured on. And this is they actually had to go on to the next season to finish this episode. So here's the end of that fight. He loses.
The boss will be here in the morning. Let's let him decide what to do with him. Put him in jail.
So in this one, Jim will lose, but come back to the same set or the same location and win. So this one's interesting in that it's a lose then win. So he's lost. Now he's back in the same place. This fellow's interesting because he fights Jim to a draw.
Now, if you gentlemen just take your hats off,
they fight and they fight, and then they get interrupted.
I just might sue old Vance.
Some other time,
it's, usually Jim is better, or the bad guys are better. These two are equal. Fight continues now.
Mr. West, you and your friend are here on official business.
You may be thinking, gentlemen, but I'm engaged. The woman has this room.
Now, special mention here for One Punch out. So he'll fight these guys and win the old-fashioned James way. One punch.
You make mess of room. I make mess of you.
All right, in there, both of you.
And here's another one punch. The fights in really close quarters didn't happen much. I could only really find two. This one's inside the train.
Kill him!
The bad guy has some kind of claw hand thing. The best of the close quarters fights is this one. This one's supposed to be happening inside a stagecoach compartment. That is just vicious.
Them.
Now, there was some where they fought unusual weapons. Here's man against swords, which he defeats in a
youthful and high-spirited,
unusual way.
I'm willing to overlook the whole matter, Mr. Singh.
Oh, no. I wouldn't think of taking advantage of your generosity. They deserve a good lesson. Boys, pay attention and learn something.
All right, boys. Class is called to order. Lesson number one. You should always keep your opponent
off balance. Oh, well done, sir. Remember those words of wisdom, children.
Lesson number two. Short of weapons, improvise. Lesson number three. Rosebud.
Rosebud? It's a box of matches.
What do you intend doing, Mr. West?
I have an insane urge to end this whole dreary charade by throwing Rosebud.
Don't be ridiculous, Mr. West.
That would be silly, wouldn't it?
Very silly, sir.
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir.
Very silly. They are matches.
By George, you're right.
Now, this one is interesting. It's katanas, which it turns out Jim knows how to fight with.
Ha!
and the bad guy gets killed by whatever in the heck that thing is.
Is off by a...
Oh. And here we have Man versus Lances. Those uniforms are called Hussar uniforms and were in use at this time. Here we have Man against Whip. Here we have Man with Gone. And these guys just spend a lot of time running back and forth. Man fighting with hole in stage. Here we have Man against Monkey. Not these monkeys. This monkey. Or this man in a monkey suit. Yeah.
It's Dr. Lovelace, of course.
And here we have Man Against Steam Man, or if you like, Steampunk.
You've outdone yourself this time, Dr. Lovelace.
I thank you, Mr. West.
And here we have a second one with the same guy, which Jim will defeat by taking away his steam. This is the only episode ever where they broke the fourth wall at the end of this fight. Oh, and crossbows and swords as well.
Where's the girl?
Now, as I was saying,
I had some really good entrances to fights. Here's the best one, I think.
Out your accounts as long as I'm an epitaph.
And what if West comes back?
I am back.
But he had lots of good entries into fights. They were very creative in trying to get things started. So here he is in this wardrobe. Here's one where he drops through two floors to begin his fight with spy dust. But my favorite is the next one, where he literally comes smashing through a wall to open the fight.
Thank you.
I hope you've enjoyed this survey of the stunt fights in the Wild Wild West. Next one up is the gunfights. I hope you will enjoy the next one as well. Bye-bye.
Say to me, I've just come back from the grave, risen like Lazarus. And that's what you say? Thanks, Artie.
Thanks, Artie.
It's a pleasure.